नमस्ते, खुश रहो बेटिया। आई जेबीएन वर्षा सिंह फ्रॉम ज्योति विद्यापीठ वीमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथडोलॉजी। इन टुडे सेशन वी विल लर्न अबाउट डिस्क शेड्यूलिंग। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू डिस्क शेड्यूलिंग इज द टॉपिक कम्स अंडर सेकेंडरी मेमोरी। एज यू नो वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ मेमोरी, प्राइमरी मेमोरी एंड सेकेंडरी मेमोरी। प्राइमरी मेमोरी इज योर रैंडम एक्सेस मेमोरी, दैट इज कॉल्ड रैम। ओके, सो सेकेंडरी मेमोरी, वी हैव नंबर ऑफ सेकेंडरी मेमोरी लाइक टेप ड्राइव, मैग्नेटिक डिस्क, हार्ड डिस्क। ओके, सो इन दिस टॉपिक वी विल अंडरस्टैंड हाउ हार्ड डिस्क इज वर्क इन योर सिस्टम। ओके, बट फॉर दिस वी विल अंडरस्टैंड द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ योर सीडी डीवीडी विच इज यूज फॉर लिसनिंग सॉन्ग। ओके, सो हियर इज द पिक्चर ऑफ योर डिस्क। सी, द अपर पार्ट ऑफ डिस्क इज कॉल्ड प्लेटर एंड द इट इन डिस्क वी हैव मेनी नंबर ऑफ डिस्क इन डिस्क इन आवर हार्ड डिस्क। सो ईच डिस्क हैव अपर सरफेस एंड लोअर सरफेस। ईच प्लेटर इज डिवाइडेड इन मेनी डिवाइडेड इंटू मेनी ट्रैक। आफ्टर दैट ईच ट्रैक हैज Each track has many sectors. Okay, I want to say that we have a platter, as you can see in this picture. Okay, the surface, the planar surface is your platter, and divided part is called track, and the sector where your data is stored. Okay, and this is the called a spindle which rotate. Okay, and with the help of this spindle your disk is also revolve arounding. Okay, and we have an arm assembly that is called armature. This have a kind of pin that is called read write head, and this is the technique which used for retrieving the data. But in this topic we have to study about the how disk scheduling give exactly that data which we want. Okay, for this we have many algorithm that is called disk scheduling, because at one time we want many number of process, you can say that, and many number of data at a time. For this how disk decided which task is performed first or not, for this we have many disk scheduling algorithm. Okay, which we will discuss in this lecture. So first of all we will understand about what is disk scheduling. Disk scheduling is done by operating system. As we know, everything is managed by operating system in your system. Okay, so disk scheduling is done by operating system to schedule input output request arriving for disk. Disk scheduling is also known as input output scheduling. The technique that operating system uses to determine the request which is used to be satisfied next is called disk scheduling. So we have to remember some basic term which will be used in the scheduling algorithm. So first we have seek times. What is seek time? Seek time is the time taken in locating the disk arm to a specified track where the read write request will be satisfied. That is called seek time. Okay, And rotational latency is the time taken by the desired sector to rotate itself to the position from where it can access the read-write head. That is called your rotational latency. And transfer time is taken to transfer the data, that is called transfer time. And disk access time is given as a rotational latency plus seek time plus transfer time, that is your disk access time. What is disk response time? It is the average of time spent by each request waiting for the input output operation, that is called your disk response time. Disk scheduling algorithm. What is the purpose of disk scheduling algorithm? So, as I told you, this algorithm is used to decide which process, which task should be done first or not. Okay. So, the main purpose of disk scheduling algorithm is to select a disk request from the request of input-output request and decide the schedule when this request will be processed or not. The disk scheduling algorithm are as follow. Which are first come and first serve. It is the simplest, you can say that it is the simplest disk scheduling algorithm. In FCFS, the requests are addressed in the order they arrive in the disk queue. Okay, so we will cover the problem solving in next session. In this session, we will only understand the concept, what is the first come first serve, and other algorithm like shortest seek time first. Okay, so see what is the advantage and disadvantage of first come and first serve scheduling algorithm. So advantage of first come and first serve scheduling algorithm is that every request gets a fair chance. No indefinite postponement. That means every process have equal chance to get the disk. Okay, an advantage is you can say that the it might be possible some task is long duration, so other task is going into starvation. So this is a problem arises in this scheduling. Okay, so let's come to the shortest seek time first. In this scheduling algorithm, requests having shortest seek time are executed first. So the seek time of every request is calculated in advance in queue, and then they are scheduled according to their calculated seek time. So it is very time consuming because it decided which is the shortest task, and then it arrange into the queue and then give the chance to acquire the disk. Okay. So as a result, the request near the disk arm will get executed first, and shortest seek time first is certainly an improvement over the first come and first serve, as it decreases the average response time and increases the throughput of the system. So that's why it helps to increase the throughput of the system. As you know, the throughput means the task executed in per unit time, that is called your throughput. Okay, so advantage of shortest seek first time is it gives the average response time decreases and throughput increases. But in this algorithm we have also disadvantages. It can cause starvation for a request if it has higher seek time as compared to incoming requests. So it might be possibility it goes into the starvation. In a scan algorithm, the disk arm moves into a particular direction and services the request coming in its path, and after reaching the end of the disk, it reverses its direction and again services the request arriving in its path. So this algorithm works like an elevator, and hence also known as elevator algorithm also. Okay, as a result, the request at the mid-range are serviced more and those arriving behind the disk arm will have to wait. So this algorithm will understand through the problematic question, then you can understand better how the throughput is increases, how the starvation is increases, how it improve, how it solve the problem one another. One of, okay, so see, in a scan it also gives the high throughput and average response time, but in this algorithm we have disadvantage, long waiting time for request for location just visited by disk arm. Okay, see, a scan means circular scan, that means in which disk arm instead of reversing its direction goes to the other end of the disk and starts servicing the request from there. So the disk arm moves in a circular fashion, and this algorithm is also similar to scan algorithm, and hence it is known as the C-scan. Advantage for this algorithm is it provides more uniform wait time compared to a scan. Okay, in look it is a similar to this scan disk scheduling algorithm, except the difference that the disk arm, in spite of going to the end of the disk, goes only to the last request to be serviced in front of the head, and then reverses its direction from there only. Thus it prevents the extra delay which occurred due to unnecessary traversal to the end of the disk. Okay, in C look, as look is it also similar like your scan, circular scan. In similar way, C look is similar to C scan disk scheduling algorithm. In C look, the disk arm, in spite of going to the end, goes only to the last request to be serviced in front of the head, and then from there goes to the other end last request. Thus it also prevents the extra delay which occurred due to unnecessary traversal to the end of the disk. So okay, everything, every sentence we will understand by numerical. I will solve in next session. Okay, your work is only you have to remind the term which has been used in this session. Okay, so please don't confuse which, if we will solve, if we will be solving in next session the numerical part, you have to be clear this term. Okay, so please first, if you want to really understand this topic, you have to understand process management first, and then you have to come this chapter, right? So in previous session I have discussed about the process management and process scheduling. So go and see that lecture and then come to this lecture, then you can better understand. Okay, so in next session we will solving the some problem in the basis of this algorithm, right? So thank you, I hope you enjoyed my session. This digital version session 2.0 is provided by Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. If any query regarding this session, please comment below. I will give some link, recommended link in description box, which can help to cover and understand practically this session. Okay, so don't worry, you will understand well. Okay, thank you.